Welcome back. Health authorities are being forced to explain why those who are still unvaccinated are among the first in line for potentially life-saving antiviral COVID treatments.
For more, we're joined by Vice President of the Australian Medical Association, Dr. Chris Moy from Adelaide. Doctor, first, what are antivirals and how effective are they?
So these are medications, either tablets or something injectable, which given in the first 5 days from the onset of symptoms can have a huge difference in terms of your chances of getting severe disease from COVID or ending up in hospital or dying. And there are there's a couple of tablets and capsules that are available from your GP, and there are medications which you, other ones which you have to go to hospital to have injections to have treatment for. But if given for the right person early enough in the treatment, they can make a big difference, although they won't beat vaccination. Vaccination is still better than these antiviral treatments.
So they're currently available for people at higher risk of severe disease, which includes people who have had fewer than 3 doses of the COVID vaccine. A lot of vaccinated people are disappointed by that. Do you get that?
Oh, yeah, I totally, and a lot of people have indicated that to me. Look, the thing is that we are in an emergency and a pandemic, and we're lacking something which is hard to get at the moment. And in a situation, the ethical principle of medicine is never to discriminate based on people's lifestyle, because I don't think any of us have not done something bad in our lives. And the thing is that what we're doing is trying to pick out the highest risk people and give that they have the greatest benefit. And those people are going to be those people who are, say, immunosuppressed, who are older, who have other conditions, or who are unvaccinated. And obviously, if you're unvaccinated, you have a higher risk of getting severe disease. Now, I do get why people go, gee, that's just not fair, they haven't bothered to get vaccinated. But the flip side is, if we're going to apply the rule about how your lifestyle was and whether we discriminated on that basis, then we wouldn't treat you if you were a smoker, if you came to hospital. So we can't start here, and we won't do that.
Doctor, this is a horror flu season, isn't it? We are in the middle of it now.
Terrible.
There are no tissues, actually, in some supermarkets. It's just, it's much more shocking than I expected it to be. What should people do? I mean, I guess we know what to do because we've been through COVID. We know how to protect ourselves, but are people getting vaccinated?
Well, the vaccination rates were behind. They really have caught up pretty well, but we still need everybody to get vaccinated because we're entering our first proper flu season for 3 years while we've got heaps of COVID at the same time. So the main things are get back to basics, get good hygiene, get vaccinated, apply good hygiene, and the most important thing from now on, irrespective about whether you're talking about COVID or flu, the first thing is you don't go to work if you're sick. You know, if you've basically really unwell, you should not be going to work like you did before, and that is the key thing.
That's a lot more acceptable now, isn't it? In fact, you'd be frowned upon for turning up sick. It's not like the old days when you sort of got a medal for turning up sick, because you'd soldiered on. What about children? Should they be vaccinated against flu?
So children over 6 months should really get vaccinated because, first up, they can get very sick as well. And you get the odd child who unfortunately gets extremely sick, and you do unfortunately see the odd death as well in children. So, and they don't have a lot of reserve. So if they get a really bad pneumonia from influenza, they can get into trouble very quickly.
I think, Doctor, I think there was a two-year-old, wasn't there a two-year-old just in the last couple of days in Brisbane who passed away with influenza? I mean, it's getting to a point now where almost every family across the eastern seaboard has someone who's really sick. How do you know the difference?
Oh, it is very hard to tell the difference. I mean, there are some characteristics about COVID which are possibly more characteristic of it, such as losing smell and taste without a runny nose, and more sort of systemic symptoms around the body rather than just the chest side of things. But look, it is very difficult, and that is why in terms of you've just got to assume you've got something first up. That's the main thing, and don't go to work and spread it around. Go get a COVID test at the very minimum, and if you're seeing a doctor, they may add something like an influenza test to that test as well to work out what you've got. Now, with COVID, if you're in the right group, you might get one of these antiviral treatments. And there's even an antiviral for flu, actually, called Tamiflu, which may be appropriate for you as well if you're in a high risk.
All right, you get yourself inside and rest that voice. Sounds like you're coming down with something. It's not today related.